I just got a box that's marked fragile on it. I'm excited. I've already cut it open, but I'm not seeing yet what's inside of it. I'm very excited. So let's take these out. Okay, oh, we have like lots of bubble wrap, like entire box is full. Guess we'll open this first. Okay, so here is the Indiana Jones fig that I ordered that looks like my old ones that I can't find. So in case I can't find it, I can build my temple set. So I'll give you a close-up of that in a second. Then I bought a set. It does this white horse and this Scooby-Doo with goggles give you a hint as to what set might be in this box. I'm very excited. I think the set is in this big huge bowl. Can you tell what it is? Oh my goodness. I'm gonna leave the instructions in there. Do you have any last guesses as to what the big set might be? Oh, he double wrapped it. Ooh. Oh goodness. Can you see what it might be? Oh, he wrapped it three times. Lucky there. Lucky there. My fan is blowing away my stuff. He had to take it apart a little bit to put it into the package. So I'll have to reference the instructions to make sure it's all together. I got the Scooby-Doo plane set. I did have the instructions right there. That's so cool. That is, yes, exciting. So I got, I think it was 100% complete too. I'll have to double check, but it looks like it's 100% complete and I paid a decent price for it. So whoops, there with Indiana Jones. Eek! Okay, we'll put Indy up there and then we have this that I'm really excited for. So we have the Shaggy with his 2x2 tile. I'm assuming it's supposed to be a newspaper. We have him for that set. And we have the Headless Horseman for that set. And what I'm most excited for this package was I finally got Daphne. That is so cool. And I got Velma! The entire gang is complete. I have Velma and Daphne. And then Freddy and Shaggy are over there. I could put them all together. I have the gang 100% complete. That is so cool. Now, unfortunately, they don't come with their accessories. But that is perfectly fine. It looks so cool. I love it. They look perfect. Like, there's no cracks or swing wear on them. So cool. I finally got Velma. That is so hard to find as a good Velma. And then I also got Daphne. She's about as hard as Velma, but not as expensive as Velma. So I was able to complete my set, get the Scooby-Doo plane with the Scooby for it. I like the Scooby from here. He has his little goggles. It's so cute. And then I also got the Indiana Jones, in case I cannot find my Indiana Jones. So, I'm so excited. It's so cool. And the stickers on this set, they look really well, like, applied. They did a good job on applying them. So first off, we have the Indiana Jones fig. This is the older one. I like how he has more hair here. Looks more stubbled. And his messed up shirt, where it actually looks like he's been exploring. And he comes with his satchel and his whip, like most of them do. He does not have an alternate face. There is no printing on the sides or arms or on the back. But this is the Indiana Jones that I grew up knowing. Of course, this is not mine because I just ordered it. But this is what I grew up knowing. I like this more than the new one, although I do like the idea of having the hair attached to the hat for the new one. Because with this one, if he had his hair, you had to take off his hat and put his hair on. So, but this is the Indy that I grew up knowing. Next, we'll look at the plane. Back you up just a little bit. So here is the plane. It is 100% complete. It does have all the stickers applied very well. It has this little chart for how many times I guess you've hit them or something or seen them. I don't remember this episode. It's been a while. I have to go find it. But here is the plane. Looks really cool. And it even has more marks over here. And of course, there's these sandwich guns. You're supposed to do the push down on this. Oh, and it shoots it into the floor even though you have your hand out. But they're little sandwiches with this, is that a sticker? No, that's printed. That is a printed hamburger bun piece on top. So that's kind of cool. And there are two of those, one on either side of the plane. Very neat. And then it has this big, huge cockpit here for Scooby. Slide that back out of the way. So here is the Scooby. I believe this is the only set where Scooby is sitting. I know for sure it's the only one where he has the goggles, which is just so cute. He looks to be in really good condition. Some of the Scoobies I've gotten, the nose has been rubbed off, but his nose looks in great shape. So I'm very excited to have this Scooby. I don't have this one yet, so that's exciting. And then this chain that's hanging off the end of the plane here is for Shaggy to hang by. And here is Mr. Shaggy. So he has his usual green with maroonish red pants. He does have a printed sleeve on his arm, but that is the only real detail. And then shirt lines on the back. His hair is very shaggy. He has his scared face right here and his smiling, about to get food face right there. He does come with this plate right here that is stolen trophy. And then you can't really tell what the stolen trophy is about. It just says stolen trophy and has a picture of the headless horseman. And here is the Headless Horseman. So first off, we have just a normal horse. I get the horseman off. There we go. We just have the normal white horse that can move its back legs and its head with the saddle. So nice horse there. And then the Headless Horseman is holding a trophy and a black sword. And it has this very nice purple cape. There are a few print details on the back, none on the sides, and then there are some, just take the trophy off, there are some on the front. And then his pumpkin head can come off and reveal who actually is the bad guy. And if you don't want to see this through the pumpkin head, you can turn it to the black on the back. That is the pumpkin guy. Put that over there. Then next up, we have Daphne. So this is a great looking Daphne. Love the purple color with the green scarf. She has some printing on the side of the legs right here. A little bit on the back of her torso. No printing on the arms. And then she has that iconic red hair with purple headband. She does not have an alternate face. She does have the green scar continuing on the back of her back. I like the little pleasant smile she has. There is a slight, I don't even know if you'll be able to see it, but there's a slight black mark right there. But it is barely noticeable unless you are looking for it. And I will be displaying her this way, not this way. So that is perfectly fine. I'm very excited to have all of my gang together. I'm going to put them in one of those shadow boxes and have the whole gang, and it's going to be so amazing. And then for the last,
most expensive part of this entire order is Velma. Velma was more expensive than the set was. This is amazing. This is probably the most expensive minifigure I own now. She has printing on the back of her torso, not on her arms. She does have some on the sides of her legs, not on the back. I love, I got the skirt going all the way around the legs. That's very nice, which they did that with Daphne as well. She has her scared face here, and then you remove her nice brown hair, and she has a smiling face over here. It looks very good. So there is no swing marks that I can see, no cracks. She's in perfect condition. So I am very happy with this. She will definitely be going in a shadow box with Miss Daphne, and then my Freddy, my Scooby, and my Shaggy. So I'm very excited for this. I finally have the whole gang. That was my main thing, was I just wanted the whole gang and the Mystery Machine. I didn't really care if I got any other sets, but this set was very cheap. And it came with the Scooby with the glasses, and or the goggles. And that is just such, that is so funny and so cute. I love that. So, very excited with what I got. This is amazing, and the trophy is trying to roll away. There we go. I'm very happy with this. I am going to go put these ones in the shadow box right now so nothing happens to them.
I am very excited about this package, and here is all of them in the shadow box. Looks so cool. I wish I could get the Mystery Machine in with it, but a little big for the shadow box. Hopefully I can find like a nice clear tote, and I could put the Mystery Machine in it and display it next to him, or something to put it in. But that is my, I got the whole Mystery Machine gang. That is so cool. Love it so much. It makes me so happy. So I have like a shelf thing that I'm gonna put on my wall, and that's where I plan on putting them, but I don't have that put up yet. So for now, they're gonna go up here in front of my Princess Bride characters. And I don't want the Mystery Machine to get covered in dust, so it's gonna stay in a bag until I do get a tote. But for now, oh, that looks so cool. There it is. It looks so cool. I like being able to have all of them with the Mystery Machine next to them. That is so neat. Well, my gang is complete now, and I'm very, very happy. So that's it for this video. I will see you all next time, and we'll continue going through Lego. And if I don't find my Indiana Jones, at least now I have this one, which I still think this is better than the new one. I'll have to, since now I have him, when I build the temple one, I will compare the two. But I do think that the old ones are always better. Like, there's just something about it. Anyway, thank you all for stopping on by. Please like, share, subscribe. I'll see you all later. Go build Lego. Let God. Bye, everybody. So here is the Lone Ranger. Lone Ranger. Oh my goodness. Hey, stop. That cat's trying to get through my blinds. And then what I'm most excited about for this. Would you stop chewing on my blinds? Leave them alone. Silly nut.